ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। शृण्वतां स्वकथा कृष्णा पुण्यश्रवणकीर्तना हृदयन्तस्तो हि अभद्राणि विदुनोति सुहृत्सतं नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवतसेवया भगवती उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिकी। समरी ऑफ द डिफरेंट चैप्टर्स ऑफ द श्रीमद् भागवतम। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनाशलाकाय चक्षुरुन्मीलितमेन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामी नित्यनाम्ने नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्री वसादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे। श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो वन चैप्टर वन। क्वेश्चंस बाय द सेजेस। द फर्स्ट थ्री वर्सेस ऑफ दिस चैप्टर आर कंसिडर्ड टू बी एक्सट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टेंट। द वेरी फर्स्ट वर्स इज अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ द एब्सोल्यूट ट्रूथ। It starts with Janmadyasya Yata, meaning Krishna as the primeval cause of all causes of creation, maintenance and destruction of all the manifested universe. This gives Sambandha Gyan, this first verse of the Srimad Bhagavatam. Also the Gayatri Mantra is hidden within the first verse of the Srimad Bhagavatam. The second verse is again very, very important and it gives Abhidheya Gyan. And this verse by itself is a definition of the real religion. Dharma Projita Kaitava, that is how the verse begins. It means that Srimad Bhagavatam completely rejects all materially motivated religion, all sorts of dharma, artha, kama and moksha, and it propounds the highest truth, which is love of God. So anyone who submissively hears the Srimad Bhagavatam can be elevated to a very high platform. The third verse is an invitation to relish the Srimad Bhagavatam. It gives Prayojana Jnan. It begins with Nigama Kalpataroor Ghalitam Phalam Shukamukadu Amrita Dhrava Samyutam Pibata Bhagavatam Rasamalayam Muhurahu Rasikabhuvi Bhavukaha. So this Srimad Bhagavatam is the mature fruit of the desire tree of Vedic literatures. And the Srimad Bhagavatam has become so tasty because of the touch of the lips of Srila Shukadeva Goswami. So this fruit that is already mature has become even more tasty because it is coming out from the lips of Srila Shukadeva Goswami. So in the further verses, we see that the scene for the sages' inquiries is being set. Once in Naimisharanya, great sages headed by Shaunaka Rishi, they assembled to perform a 1,000-year sacrifice for the satisfaction of the Supreme Lord and his devotees. So they were performing this huge sacrifice and their face was covered with soot and they appeared really, really worried. Then one day, as the sages were performing their morning duties, they saw Suta Goswami who appeared on the scene. So as soon as they saw Suta Goswami, they felt very relieved because they could understand the exalted position of Suta Goswami. They saw that Suta Goswami was free from all vices. He was well versed in scriptures like the Puranas and the other histories. He was a learned Vedantist. He was very gentle, pure and simple, and he was very submissive. So seeing Suta Goswami present there in their assembly, the sages asked him questions. These are celebrated as the six questions by the sages. The very first question they asked is, what is the absolute and what is the ultimate good for people in general? So we all know in Kali Yuga, the lifespan of all the people is very, very short. People are quarrelsome, we are lazy, we are misguided, unlucky, we are always disturbed. So the sages were inquiring, what is the best for the people in the age of Kali? That was the first question that they asked. The second question they asked was, explain the essence of all scriptures for the good of all living beings. The third, why did the Lord appear in the womb of Devaki as the son of Vasudeva? So these were the first three questions that they asked. These sages, they were all so eager to hear about these topics, and they were eager to hear more and more about the Lord's holy name and how the Lord immediately sanctifies anyone who comes in contact with him. The fourth question they asked was, they asked Suta Goswami to describe the Lord's adventures and his various incarnations, the various Purushavataras. The fifth question they asked was, they asked him to narrate the transcendental pastimes of the Lord's multiple incarnations, like the Leelavataras. So like this, they had no satiation because they just wanted to hear more and more about the wonderful activities of the Lord. They really wanted to hear about Lord Krishna's pastimes, especially because Krishna, along with Balram, they played the role of a human being, and they performed superhuman acts being the Supreme Lord. So knowing that Kali Yuga had begun, they really wanted to hear in great length about Krishna. Then the sixth question they asked was, whom did the religious principles take shelter of after Lord Krishna's departure? So these were the six questions that were asked by the sages. With this, the summary of the first chapter of the first canto ends. Hare Krishna.